Welcome to Northern Lights over Arkham. I'm JP and this time I'm deck testing Carolyn Fern. This investigator was actually voted the most worst solo investigator over at Facebook Arkham Horror the Card Game Group. I'm here to prove that Carolyn is not that bad as majority thinks. So let's look at the deck a bit. So Carolyn is a guardian investigator, but her deck's construction is a bit weird. Her deck construction is guardian cards level 0 to 3, neutral cards level 0 to 5, cards that heal horror level 0 to 5, up to 15 seeker and or mystic cards level 0 to 1. She also has an additional restriction, no weapon cards level 1 to 5, so she can only take level 0 weapons. As a solo investigator, she has to have some way to fight enemies. There are two options to go. Either you go by the mystic road and boost up her willpower. I've chosen to go the other route, so Carolyn has two 45 automatics and two enchanted blades. Also included two warning shots. The warning shot is a card not much used in deck construction. It's so-called binder fodder card. Many people think it's just bad, but I want to make it work, so that is why it's in the deck. So let's see if we can make it work in this playthrough. Other cards that Carolyn has a lot are cards that heal horror. For example, Liquid Courage from the Rogue card pool is really good in Carolyn. I've added Hallowed Mirror that doubles as a horror healing card with the soothing melodies and also as a damage healing card. Then there's one Second Wind to help with the healing. And to get all of our necessary cards, I've added Mr. Rook. And of course, Peter Sylvester is almost an auto include in Carolyn when you're playing solo. In multiplayer, you might end up in a situation where a survivor or survivor of class wants to use Peter, so there's a bit of negotiation who can utilize Peter Sylvester the best. Other than that, there are basic staple cards like Take the Initiative is really good in solo. Unexpected Courage is always quite okay card. And instead of Emergency Cases, I've opted to include Crack the Case, because sometimes you can get more resources with Crack the Case than you would with Emergency Cash. And also, as it is a fast action, you don't have to spend an action to get the resources. Carolyn in herself has a powerful resource generation ability, because every time she heals a horror from a card she controls, she gets one resource. That's enough of the deck. Let's look what we're playing today. So I decided to play the Extracuricular activity, but the Return to version. So we're playing that, and there are some enemies, a lot of moving and glue getting in this scenario. So this is a good scenario to test a level 0 deck in. So let's get going. If you like my content, hit the subscribe button so you don't miss anything. So I've pre-shuffled the decks. So let's draw our opening hand of 5 cards. We get Take the Initiative, 45 automatic, another 45 automatic, and Hypochondria is discarded physical training. I think I'll discard these two to draw two. Forbidden Knowledge and Magnifying Glass, so a really okay start. I think our first turn is mostly set up, and then we start looking for clues. We have 5 resources to play the magnifying glass and the weapon down right away. And I think we play the forbidden knowledge and start taking some horror to get more resources to play the physical training down fast. First action, we play the 4-5 automatic. It's 4 resources. Gets 4 ammo. And as a fast action, I'll play the magnifying glass. And as a second action, I play the forbidden knowledge. There's 4 secrets on it. And I think I'll exhaust it right away. Spend 1 to gain 1 and take 1 horror. Last action. I'll move into the Orn library. Okay, let's check. 1 action, 2 action, fast action, 3 triggered ability. Ooh, so 3 actions, yeah. We gain 1 resource. We draw 1 card. This is unexhausted. We get Mr. Rook. Nice. Will help us to find the cards we really need. Okay, so that's the first turn. Let's go to the second turn, after I add the clue there. We add a doom on the agenda. The threshold is 7, so 1 of 7 doom. We get an encounter card, and which is Haunting Recollections. For each card in your hand, if there is a copy of that card in your discard pile, take 1 horror. If you take no horror from this effect, discard the top 3 cards of your deck. Well, our discard is empty, so we discard 3 cards from the top of our deck. We lose the Enchanted Blade, Hallowed Mirror, and Peter Sylvestre. So, not really keen on seeing those get discarded. First action, I'll play down the physical training. I'll exhaust the forbidden knowledge and take 1 horror. Get 1 resource. And I'll investigate. And because we are at the Orn library, I must spend 1 additional action to investigate. So I'm 5 versus 3. Skull is a minus 1. I don't fail, so I don't have to discard anything. I get the clue. And that's our turn. No enemy phase. We go to upkeep. Draw 1 card. Crack the case a bit late. Well, what can you do? We get 1 resource. And we can go to the next turn. We add another doom onto the agenda. And we draw a Vassal of the Lurker. So, really fast we get an enemy. I think we just need to kill this enemy off. So, first action, I'll take the initiative and use the 45 automatic to shoot. This would have been readied. So I am 7 versus 3. It's a plus 1. We do 2 damage. Second action, I'll shoot again. This time I'll spend 2 resources with physical training to boost the shot. And I'm 5 versus 3. Minus 1. So we managed to kill the enemy off. And it's a victory endpoint enemy, so it goes to the victory display. Next, last action, we'll move to the humanities building. Okay, that was something I didn't remember. So there's a forced ability. At the end of your turn, if you are at the humanities building, discard the top X cards of your deck, where X is the amount of horror on you. And unfortunately, we have two horror on us, so we discard two cards. And well, luckily we discarded our weakness and take an initiative. That was not nice to discard. Okay. So, no enemy phase, we go to upkeep. We get an enchanted blade and one resource. Okay, let's go to the next turn. We add another doom, get an encounter card, and hopefully not an enemy. Beyond the Veil, there's nothing we can do about that. We just have to finish the scenario or resign before that triggers. So it has surge, so we get another card. It's a troll. Location with the most clues, so it spawns on our location. Well, well. I think we just need to kill the troll, so first action we'll shoot. I'll use the resource from here. I am 4 versus 2. Minus 1. Troll is dead. Second action, we'll investigate. 5 versus 3. Minus 2, we get a clue. And last action, we'll investigate. 5 versus 2. 5 versus 3, so minus 2 or better. It's a skull, so minus 1, we get the clue. We play crack the case. We get 3 resources. And we have to discard 2 cards. We lose drawn to the flame and drawn to the flame. Well, that was not really good. No enemies, we go to upkeep. We get an unexpected courage and another resource. So now we have a decent way to boost our fight with all of these resources. It helps out a lot. And that's that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom, get an encounter card, resurgent evils. I have to choose either to draw 2 cards from the encounter deck or place 1 doom on the current agenda. I will place the doom any day. Well, not maybe any day, but at this situation. We could spend... Actually, we spend our clues. Should have done this at the end of the last turn. So we shuffle the encounter discard pile and the Jazz Mulligan into the encounter deck. And now we have to find Jazz, because can't move into the locked place, and this should be not revealed. Okay, so we can spend clues to discard 5 cards from the top of the encounter deck, and actually 10 cards because it's a 1-player game. First action, I will move to Miss Catonic Quad. And let's go to the Students Union. Okay, so there's two clues here. Last action, we'll investigate. So I'm 5 versus 1. -2. We get one clue from here. And that's our turn. No enemy phase. We go to the upkeep. We get another unexpected courage and get another resource. That's our turn. Let's go to the next turn. We have 6 of 7 doom. Get an encounter card, which is Haunting Recollections. For each card in your hand, if there is a copy of that card in your discard pile, take one horror. There is an enchanted blade, so we take one horror. And first action, I'll spend the clue to discard 10 cards from the top of the encounter deck. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. No jazz. Second action, I'll investigate. I'm 5 versus 1, so -4 or better. -2. And we use our last action to again search the 10 cards for jazz. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Nice, we found jazz. It was cleaning the door, student union. So next turn we need to parlay with jazz to get access to other parts of the university campus. That's our turn. No enemies. We go to upkeep. We get a second wind and another resource. Let's go to the next turn. So we advance the Quiet Halls agenda. I only have 9 cards in the discard, so I take one horror. And really start getting some horror healing going on. First action, just so that I don't waste actions, I'll commit the unexpected courage to talk to Jazz. Carolyn is a shy girl, so she needs some courage to talk to this handsome janitor for some reason. I'm 6 versus 3 for the test. +1, well, she had it all along. So we take control of Jazz and we advance the act. So we put into play the alchemy labs, faculty offices, and the dormitories. And because we have jazz, we can move into those locations. And we also put down the experiment. And it starts from the alchemy labs. Oh yeah, this doesn't come into play yet. But this would have come into play when we entered the student union. So Campus safety. We have to find and complete an objective on another encounter card. Well, I think because we're here to look for Professor Warren Rice, we go look for Professor Warren Rice. First action was to parlay with Jazz, so second action I'll actually play down Mr. Rook. And we right away search for something. I think we could search for. So I search 9 cards. Let's see what we get. We get our weakness. So we put 4 horror on the rational thought. I think we are not doing much of horror healing in this scenario. We have warning shot per. Perception, liquid courage, forbidden knowledge, perception, physical training, magic, magnifying glass, and liquid courage. I think because we opt to go to look for Rice, I'll take the warning shot. If we get enemies, we can fend them off with the warning shot. So we shuffle these back into our deck. It's getting quite empty, so we have to be mindful of not drawing too much so we don't trigger the Beyond the Veil. We move second action. Did I do already 2 actions? So first action was parlay with Jazz. No, the first action was getting glue, then parlay, then we move to the Miskatonic Quad. Okay, no enemies. We go to upkeep, get a perception, and 1 resource. That's our turn. Let's go to the next turn. We get a doom onto the agenda. We draw 1 encounter card, and it's Light of Avermon. I'll put it onto the agenda because it will advance quite soon. Rook should be readied. So that's the Mythos phase. We move into the administration building. There's 1 clue here. We are not interested in clues right at the moment. So first action, we put the faculty offices into play. And because we are playing this as standalone, we use the Night is Still Young version. So second action, I'll move to faculty offices. And after faculty offices is revealed, search the encounter deck and discard pile for a humanoid enemy and spawn it here. Shuffle the encounter deck. So good thing we got the warning shot. Well, let's see which. Let's search the. I think we'll get the troll. It's easier to deal with than the security guard. I think as the last action. I actually don't need to kill the troll. So, objective, if investigators in the faculty offices spend 2 clues per investigator as a group, I advance to R1. So that is my goal. Last action, I'll use warning shot. I'll spend 1 ammo. two resources for this event. And I move all non-elite enemies at your location to a connecting location. So this moves here. We don't have to deal with the troll. Okay, enemy phase. No hunters, so we go to upkeep. I draw a card. I get a 45 automatic. That's good, because if we get more enemies, we can deal with them by playing that. And I get one resource. So that's the turn. Let's go to the next turn. We get another Doom. And counter card is Beyond the Veil. It searches. Secret door. We can't leave this location. Well, I'm not leaving this location, so it doesn't matter. First action, I'll investigate. I'll use unexpected courage, so I'm 7 versus 2. Minus 1, we get one clue. So, last action, I'll use perception for this second investigate. To get the last clue, and then we can advance. Auto fail. Well, dang. Have nothing more to spend, so last action, I'll just investigate 5 versus 2. Zero. So we get the last clue. We use them and we get resolution 1. So we find Rice, we don't save the students, and that's it. So the deck performed quite well. Instead, I think I still need to try the warning shot out more, but I like that I didn't have to fight the troll even and risk a bad token pull, because then I would have been in a quite difficult spot with that troll. So we just opted to shoot a warning shot and move it out from the faculty offices so we could investigate that piece. So the scenario is quite enemy heavy. There are a lot of enemies here. And let's see. Yeah, more Reaper wheels, and that's it. So I think people think that Carolyn is a bad solo investigator because her fight is not that good, but there are ways to boost the fight with physical training, for example, and having cards to commit to the tests in your deck. That way you can pass those fight checks, and of course having something to just get rid of enemies at your location, like warning shot, is good. There are some cards in the mystic pool also that help to deal with enemies, but then you should build your deck around the will boosting, not combat boosting. Then you could also have fighting with shriveling and stuff like that. But yeah, that's the deck. Let me know in the comments down below what you thought about the deck. And thanks for watching. Until next time.